Hello, thanks for joining me today as we discuss internships. Throughout the presentation today, we'll explore what an internship is, the importance of it, how you should prepare, and how to be successful in your internships. Let's get started. What exactly is an internship or a co-op? An internship is a paid or unpaid single semester experience that potentially earns the students between 1 and 3 credit hours towards their degree program. A co-op is a little different. It's a paid experience that usually requires a commitment of multiple semesters or 1 semester working full-time. It can potentially earn students 1 to 3 credit hours each semester they complete it. Co-ops can be alternating, so rotating semesters of full-time employment, or they can be parallel, so continuous part-time employment over several semesters. While earning academic credit for internships or co-ops is not required, it is highly encouraged. However, if you are not able to fit it into your degree program, ODU does offer a 0-credit option of UNIV 068, in addition to the credited internship options. This option allows students to display their internship on their academic transcript for future employers or graduate schools to be able to see. There are many reasons that you should consider completing an internship or a co-op experience throughout your undergraduate degree program. First, internships will allow you to gain excellent job experience and acquire focus in your future career field. Internship experiences are extremely helpful in figuring out what you may or may not like about a certain field, which can be beneficial to you in the long run when you're applying for jobs after graduation. Additionally, internships can give you the opportunity to enhance your classroom performance because of the hands-on practical skills that you're using in a professional environment. It also allows you to work on building a professional network through supervisors at your internship, other employees at the company, and potentially other interns. Having an internship experience also allows you to negotiate a higher starting salary after graduation because you already have professional experience in the field under your belt. While internships are a learning opportunity for students, you'll still have to go through a complete application process and potentially compete with other students for the same internship position. However, there are strategies to help you be competitive for a position. First, you want to ensure that you are able to earn and maintain good grades throughout your program. Good academic standing is considered to be a 2.0 or above here at ODU, but it is not uncommon for internships to have a requirement for a higher GPA, such as a 3.0 or above. Another thing you want to consider is being active on campus. Participation in other clubs, organizations, or campus activities will help you build your network for potentially finding an internship. It will also give you great experience to be able to highlight on your resume. Similar to getting involved on campus, participating in volunteer activities, whether it be on campus or in the community, is also a great idea to gain additional skills to help you prepare for your internship. Lastly, participating in other experiential learning opportunities will help you stand out from your peers within the application process. This can be previous internships or co-op opportunities that you've completed, externships, micro-internships, undergraduate research, or any study abroad experience. These are all things to keep in mind throughout your college experience to begin building your professional skills and career. In the College of Business, there are some requirements to be able to be eligible for academic credit for your internship. First, you must remain in good academic standing with the university. As we discussed on the last slide, here at ODU, that is maintaining a minimum GPA of a 2.0. The College of Business also requires that students are at least junior standing, so have completed at least 60 credit hours, and are officially declared in the College of Business. If you aren't sure if you're officially declared, you can always reach out to your advisor to confirm. You are also required to meet with Career Development Services for an internship eligibility appointment, where we will work with you to confirm that you meet the requirements. This is extremely important because you are not able to register yourself for the internship class as a student. You will need to go through the CDF staff for the College of Business to be given the override for the class. Although it's not required, many employers do prefer that students have completed a certain amount of credit hours and have a 3.0 or higher GPA. If this is a preference or a requirement for the internship you're applying for, it will most likely be listed on the internship description. Additionally, the internship or co-op position that you're applying for or obtain must be directly related to your major or minor learning objectives and be approved by a faculty advisor. This is to ensure that students are getting academic credit for an experience that is going to grow their skills in their field. At our internship eligibility meeting, CDS staff will discuss with you the process of how to receive faculty approval as well. Now that we've discussed the requirements to be eligible, let's take a look at what it means to be internship ready. Students must be internship ready and internship eligible to register for an internship or cooperative education course for academic credit. First, you want to go ahead and schedule an appointment with CDS staff to review and complete your resume that you'll use on your internship application. So it's important to get done. You may also email it directly to careercoach@odu.edu and receive feedback that way. Next, during your appointment, you need to make any necessary changes to your resume for CDS approval. We will work with you to make changes and suggestions to improve and strengthen your resume. After you have completed your approved resume, you will need to log into your Careers for Monarchs account and upload the document. Now, we've talked about meeting with your CDS staff members to confirm your internship eligibility and make sure your internship is ready. So, who's on our CDS staff? On our team, we have four individuals who work specifically with the Strom College of Business students. Casey, Jill, and Katie take individual appointments with students, and Chelsea works with students on their paperwork for the internship class and helps them get registered. To schedule an appointment with us, please use the Calendly link on the slide.
International students are also encouraged to complete internships throughout their program, but should be aware of additional requirements. All international students must attend a CPT, Curricular Practical Training, workshop that's given by the Office of International Student Services. All CPT paperwork must be completed before the student is able to start their internship or co-op experience. If you have any additional questions or need information on this process, visit the Visa Office website. Now that we've discussed what an internship is and how to be considered eligible and ready, it's time to talk about how to find an internship. First, we recommend using ODU's Careers for Monarchs website. This is a website specifically for current ODU students and alumni. Employers that come to us specifically requesting to work with ODU students are encouraged to create an account and frequently post their positions on here. We recommend checking at least 2 times a week for any added internships. We'll talk more about how to use this on the next slide. Another helpful addition to your search is networking. This can be with your peers, your family, family friends, or professors. We suggest making a list of anyone you know who might be able to help you in your internship search and reaching out to them accordingly. They might not have anything for you at the moment, but there's a possibility that they could connect you with someone you do not already know to discuss opportunities. Along with networking, we suggest attending CDS events on campus and online. Throughout the semester, we will offer a mixture of virtual and socially distanced on-campus opportunities to meet with employers. Additionally, check out any job search sites, company websites, and LinkedIn for internship postings. It can be helpful to also set up alerts on each of those sites so that you can get notifications to your emails when any new internships are posted. As I mentioned in the last slide, Careers for Monarchs is an online job database specifically for ODU students. It includes all kinds of job postings, such as full-time opportunities, internship and co-op listings, on-campus federal work-study student employment, and part-time employment. It also includes employer profiles who post their opportunities on Careers for Monarchs. It contains upcoming events, such as on-campus interview schedules, information sessions from employers, career fairs, or seminars going on around campus. As a student, you have access to Careers for Monarchs during your degree program and for life as an alumni. You are able to upload an approved copy of your resume and apply for jobs directly from the site. Careers for Monarchs can be accessed from your MyODU portal or the CDS website. So what's next? You're going to want to go ahead and meet with your CDS staff member to confirm that you are eligible and create or update your resume that you want to use to be able to apply for internships. After that, you can start logging in to Careers for Monarchs to view open opportunities. This will also help you identify employers that you might want to intern for and what internship positions they might have open. Like we discussed on the last slide, you are also going to want to make sure that you are attending any career events that are offered to explore internship opportunities of employers that are attending. Then you are ready to apply for and obtain your internship or co-op experience. Now that you have an internship, we're going to focus on how to be successful at your internship site. Over the next couple of slides, we are going to explore some common skills that employers have reported being attributed to their most successful interns. This includes how to develop critical thinking and problem-solving skills, improving your oral and written communication, collaborating and working in a team, mastering information technology applications used at your site, gaining leadership skills, exhibiting professionalism and a strong work ethic, and managing your own personal career growth. One skill to ensure success throughout your internship is developing critical thinking and problem-solving skills. This allows you as an intern to exercise sound reasoning to analyze issues, make decisions, and overcome problems that you might face at your site. It also allows you to practice obtaining, interpreting, and using knowledge, facts, and data appropriately in a practical setting within your field. Additionally, it allows you as an intern to demonstrate originality and inventiveness. An example of this would be seeking out new projects that you see a need for at your site and taking initiative to execute those. Another skill to work on while in your internship is growing your communication skills within the workplace. Throughout an internship, you should be able to articulate your thoughts and ideas clearly and effectively to persons inside and outside of your organization. You will also have the opportunity to practice public speaking skills and expressing ideas to others. To help with your written communication, you can volunteer to write or edit professional memos, letters, emails, or any complex reports that are relevant to your field. You should also ensure that you are using proper telephone etiquette and returning voicemails in a timely manner at your internship site. In your written communication, make sure you are using appropriate formatting, language, and verbiage. You will also want to make sure to proofread any of your work before sending or submitting it. Lastly, make sure that you are aware of your nonverbal communication as well. This consists of your posture, tone, and eye contact. Our nonverbal communication makes up for about 80% of our individual communication, making it extremely important to be mindful of in the workplace. While we're on the topic of communication, we also want to address professional email components. First, you want to make sure that you always have an appropriate greeting that addresses the individual formally. Additionally, you want to make sure that you always include a subject in your email message and make it as specific as possible. This allows whoever you're communicating with to have a clear understanding of what the conversation is before they even open your email. Another important aspect of written communication is minding your manners. Ensure that you are using please and thank you and asking questions rather than making demands of the recipient. You will also want to ensure that your writing is formal by writing in complete sentences and being concise. Another aspect of formal writing is being professional. Make sure that you are not using phrasing like text messaging language, all caps, excessive exclamation points, slang, or any emoticons in your email. When you're done writing the body of your email, make sure to check for spelling, grammar, and proofread before sending it. You should also use a signature that includes your full name and your contact information. Throughout your internship, you will have the opportunity to gain skills and succeed in collaboration and working in a team. One important thing to note about collaborating at your internship is learning and understanding the company or office culture. This will give you an idea of how employees interact and communicate to be effective together at that specific site. It will also benefit you to start building professional relationships with colleagues and customers that you're working with throughout your time there. You will also have the opportunity to begin working within a team structure and working to eliminate or manage any conflict that might arise with those colleagues. This can be a learning experience during an internship, but a vital skill to take with you into the job field and to be able to talk about at interviews. Another skill to keep in mind while you're collaborating and working within your team is to understand and appreciate multicultural diversity within your company or your site. Another way to succeed in your internship is to master information technology applications that you'll be using. First, you want to make sure and select appropriate technology to accomplish tasks that you have been given as an intern. This might take some planning ahead of time to ensure that you have the tools to meet your technology needs for whatever your role may be. It also might be a good idea to ask your internship site ahead of time if they'll be providing anything for you or if you will be expected to bring your own technology. Additionally, if you know what technology, platforms, or softwares you're going to be using prior to your internship, you should try to attend any free trainings that are available for those to start to gain your skills even before setting foot on site. Additionally, you want to ensure that you're using computing skills to be able to solve any problems that may come your way. Leadership skills are a vital part to any role you will have in the future. By completing an internship, you have the opportunity to observe and emulate leaders that you meet at your time there. You can see how leaders delegate work, coach, and develop skills of those around them, including yourself. During your internship, feel free to start practicing by using your ability to organize and prioritize to show your leadership. It might also be beneficial for you to take notes, journal, or participate in some type of reflective work to track your learning throughout your experience. Working with and watching other leaders is one of the best ways to shape and grow in your own personal leadership style. Professionalism and a strong work ethic are key to success in your internship. One way to exhibit professionalism is to dress appropriately for the environment in which you're working. As an intern, make sure you are following the dress code of the company you're working for. If it's not a clear dress code, feel free to ask your supervisor or hiring manager what would be appropriate for you to wear for the position. Another way to exhibit professionalism and your work ethic is demonstrating personal accountability. Personal accountability includes a number of things. First, arriving to work on time is essential. If you need to miss work, inform your supervisor as far in advance as possible. While on the topic of attendance, try and make personal appointments outside of your internship hours if you can. You should also be using the appropriate phone etiquette and format for responses. Another way to show accountability is to ask for feedback from your supervisor and show you are learning from your mistakes. Lastly, you can hold yourself accountable by managing your time well and prioritizing different work tasks. For some of these suggestions, you might want to ask about company policies, specifically for absences or sick time, communication policies, or anything else that will help give you clear expectations. Lastly, to ultimately be successful in your internship, you are in charge of managing your own career growth. Your company or supervisor will likely have a structure or program designed ahead of time, specifically for your internship. But you might have specific experiences you want out of your internship, so don't be afraid to ask for those as well. This can include attending any available company trainings or meetings that you might feel that are important for your growth, finding a mentor at your internship, being able to identify and articulate skills or experiences you've gained, identify areas where you need to grow by asking for constructive criticism and making the appropriate changes. You may also use evaluations to focus on skills that are valued by the employer. Additionally, you can advocate for yourself to have new opportunities if available, such as extending your internship into the next semester or part-time employment after your internship semester is over. After you finish an internship, it is so important to make sure that you update your resume. It will be much easier for yourself to do this directly after or during an internship rather than waiting until you are searching for a job. On your resume, explain your experience thoroughly, including the company you worked for, the dates you worked for them, your title, and a thorough description of your accomplishments from the internship. You should also be focusing on the skills that you gained during that time and make sure to add details, like any important projects or assignments you completed, getting a promotion or a raise, any new skills you learned, or accomplishing something significant. In your description of your experience, try to use hard numbers as well if you can, such as increase productivity by 20%, manage $3,000, or created 600 error-free files. This will help you create a specific and clear description of your experience. Thank you all for joining us today to discuss the importance of internships and how to succeed in them. If you have any additional questions or need assistance, please reach out to us. We are located in the Undergraduate Advising Suite on the first floor of Constant Hall. You may also use our Calendly link to schedule individual appointments or visit our main center at 220 Webb on the second floor above Starbucks.